According to my phone, I am in the middle of Times Square in New York City. This is not New York City.
Welcome to All Things Secured. My name's Josh, and while I understand the advantages of having a GPS on our phones, I'm also keenly aware that we are keeping a GPS tracking device all day, every day in our pockets. Now, that tracking device can be used to figure out where we live, where we work, our favorite coffee shops, and as an expat living overseas, it's often used to restrict the websites, services, and content that I can access. And I find that very unfair and discriminatory. So we're going to talk about how to hack into our phone's GPS and change things to our advantage. Now, there are a lot of great uses for this, but I also want to talk about some of the risks involved. Oh, and don't be a stranger. Make sure you click that subscribe button so you get more great content for your online security and privacy. Okay, let's go ahead inside and show you how to change the GPS on your phone.
All right, let me be clear before we get started here. I discourage people from jailbreaking your iPhone, and that's not what we're going to be doing here. Apple has excellent built-in security features, and jailbreaking your phone forfeits all that security and exposes you to unnecessary risk, especially if you don't know what you're doing. So instead of jailbreaking, we're temporarily altering the GPS settings, a change that can easily be reversed either by doing what I'm about to show you all over again or by simply restarting your iPhone. So we're not making any permanent changes to your phone here, don't worry. Here's how it works. All right, I'm going to be using a software called iMyPhone. I haven't downloaded anything on my phone. This is only going on to my computer. And so I've connected my phone to my computer. And now that I've started this, it's going to fetch my GPS location. Now, I am here in Thailand. I'm going to show you my phone simultaneously so you can see what Google Maps says as well. It says that I am in Thailand. And so we've matched that up. But let's say I want to move over to Times Square in New York City. So I'm going into iMyPhone, I'm choosing Times Square, and then I'm going to click Move. Now you notice immediately on my phone here on the right, it's going to redirect, it shows that I'm in New York City. And as far as any other app on my phone is concerned, that is where I am. And that's really interesting. One of the things iMyPhone can do is I can set waypoints, and then you see I'm changing my speed to, let's say, a brisk 8.5 kilometers an hour, and I can start to move. I can make it look like I'm actually walking down the streets of New York. And if you look to the right, it's very subtle, but I am moving down the streets of New York City as far as my iPhone's concerned. And of course, I'm still just sitting here. So I can stop that, and I can actually change the speed that I do that. Let's say I make it want to look like I'm riding my bicycle down the streets of New York City or driving a car. I can set that speed at which I'm doing any of this to now 16.5 kilometers, and you'll notice that I'm starting to go a little bit faster now on my phone. All of this just gives me a lot of control, and I can stop that at any point that I want. Up here on the upper right, I can set waypoints. So it's not just one direction, but I can go in many different directions. I can teleport to any other place that I want, and I can access the historical records of where I've been or save certain spots or routes that I want to do time and again. And of course, any time that I want to undo all of this, I can just disconnect my phone, restart it, and all of a sudden I'm back to my regular GPS settings. The downside to doing this is that you need to physically plug in your iPhone to your computer. And if you're like me, you rarely do that anymore. Heck, I had to go dig around and find where my cable was. So when might you use this feature? Well, for those who love location-based games like Pokemon Go, this allows you to explore different areas that weren't available to you before. Now, honestly, I don't play these games. I don't really like them. It makes no difference to me, but apparently it's a big deal, or at least it was. And people like being able to find rare Pokemon in other geographic locations. For me, I've used this with certain streaming services that require me to verify my location via GPS in order to watch specific content. In the past, a VPN has usually worked just fine for this. But like I just said, some services are going that extra step and checking the GPS location on my device, or at least requiring me to check in at my home location every once in a while. Now, when I have to do that now, I simply change my GPS location with this software, check in with the service provider, and then reset the location on my iPhone. There are other instances where I can see a need to fake my location for those who might be tracking me. And I realize that, like most technology, this can be used both for good and bad purposes. So I'm not advocating that you use this to trick your wife into thinking that you're in one place when you're actually in another. But let's say that someone's in an abusive situation and somebody's tracking their phone as a means of controlling them. Well, by all means, fake your GPS data and head to the nearest location to find help. But I think that's a rare use case. At least I hope it is. More often than not, I'm using this just to access geo-restricted services. One last thing. You need to understand the risks involved with using this kind of service, minimal as they may be. I spoke with an iPhone representative who confirmed to me that their company does collect limited data, including your device serial number, the hardware you're using, the software you're using, and of course, your GPS location. Apple ensures that the app has its own sandbox, so it doesn't have access to all the other data on your iPhone. However, I would caution that iPhone is a Chinese company, which means that the Chinese government now, or possibly in the future, will have backdoor access to any data they have. It shouldn't be much, it shouldn't be identifiable, but that is a risk. So what do you think? Is there value in changing your GPS data on your phone? Let me know in the comments below, and you can help me a ton by hitting that like button before you move on to the next video. Stay safe.